Right now, it's a big topic in the United States of America. The impeachment inquiry of President Donald Trump has really captured the news and obviously the news of the world. Well, let me just tell you something. Yesterday, I believe it was yesterday, maybe it was the day before, I did a quid pro quo. That's right. I did a quid pro quo. In fact, I think I've done a number of them. And that's the conversation. And let me ask you, have you ever done a quid pro quo? Well, if you'll give me a few minutes, perhaps we can take the subject of the day and put it in a context that helps us to better understand the times and better know what to do, and perhaps even ask the question about what does it mean for you and for me as a Christian entrepreneur? A brief program today, but I hope it'll be helpful and useful to you. It begins right now. This is Stan Houston. The program is The Master Entrepreneur, brought to you by TCENglobal.org, which is where we hang out for the Christian Entrepreneur Network. And we're the sponsor of the program, and hopefully you'll join us in sponsoring us and sponsoring the program too at TCENglobal.org/contribute now. Well, what about the quid pro quo, which is a Latin expression which everybody throws around, but of course most people have never heard of it, and those who've heard of it now perhaps don't really understand what it's all about. Well, let me see if I can give you a little bit of a help as I understand it, and please keep in mind I'm a real amateur about this. However, I do know that one of the things we want to do is, and I've taken this as a motto for years, it said that King David had a group of men and women, and they were the people of Issachar. Issachar, kind of a group of advisors around him as he sought to lead the kingdom of Israel as it became a mighty, somewhat almost an empire at that time. And it said, the men and women of Issachar, the people of Issachar, they understood the times and they knew what to do. And for many years, I've oftentimes coached employers to understand that they should have some Issachar people in their fellowship of friends and colleagues and perhaps with their employees. Issachar, help us to better understand what's going on. What's up, Doc? As the Bugs Bunny consultant used to say. What's going on, and what should we do? Help us to better understand the times and know what to do. Well, yes. Here's what happened. I went and I wanted to get my car washed. And it needs a good polishing. It needs to be really well done. I do it myself quite often, but I need to make sure it's done well so it doesn't rust out and it looks good. And then when I do it myself, it's better. So I went and asked for a professional car wash. Well, he said, for $25, we can do that. And we agreed. That, my friends, in very simple ways, was a quid pro quo. He agreed that he would wash my car and polish it and make it look very, very nice. But he wasn't going to do it for nothing. He wanted something. What did he want? He wanted $25. That was the quid pro quo. And you see, now you're beginning to get it. Almost everything in life and business tends to reflect a quid pro quo. I want my shirts cleaned. Well, I go to the nice family laundry down the street, and they know me, and they like me, and they appreciate me, and I like them, but they don't do my shirts for free. They ask that I will pay a fee. And It's very agreeable to both of us. They get the money and their services are compensated, and I have a lot of time and energy that I save by not doing the shirts myself. Now, to better understand a little bit of the context, you need to understand that one of the things that motivates, in many ways, the leader of the United States, Donald Trump, he is a businessman. He's not a politician, and he's a tough-nosed businessman. And of course, he made his reputation as a young man. I oftentimes say, write your first book before you're 40. He was about 38, 39, maybe just about 40. He wrote a book called The Art of the Deal. The Art of the Deal. And if you want to understand the man and understand a lot of where he comes from, you have to understand that that was very vital. What's the deal? And so in his dealings with the Chinese, one of the reasons he was very, very upset is he thought the quid pro quo between China and the United States was a bad deal. And he believes that if you have a bad deal, you should make it a better deal, a better quid pro quo. Life and business is full of quid pro quos. And part of what we do, part of the wisdom that we have to seek, remember, as a Christian entrepreneur, we seek God's special wisdom. Hey, and it's to know what we should do and how to do it well. And we have all kinds of opportunities. We have all kinds of people trying to sell us things. We have customers who are negotiating with us and trying to get a deal from us. Give us the wisdom to be wise and kind and good and ethical and Jesus-pleasing in the deals that we make, in the deals that we do. May we really reflect the spirit of kindness and goodness and fairness and understanding. But may we also do that in the spirit of knowing that we have our obligations to meet, our families to support, and our businesses to sustain. And so give us the wisdom to know when we should say no to the deal and when we should say yes to the deal. That's it. In a very simple explanation, that's a quid pro quo. And I just simply ask you to let that sit on your head and then perhaps decide what you will want to do as a Christian entrepreneur as you build your business. What are the standards you have for the deals that you will do and the promises you will make? I'm Stan Houston. This is The Master Entrepreneur. We'd appreciate your sponsorship. TCENGlobal.org/contribute now. TCENGlobal.org/contribute now. Now, give me a few moments and we'll talk about, does God have a quid pro quo? Stay tuned. And just in a few moments, that's a great question. First of all, God does not always quid pro quo us. What if God gave us totally what we deserved? You know, us fallen, sinful men and women, what if he revoked grace and mercy and love and then gave us exactly what we deserved? Oftentimes people say, I only want what I deserve. And I've got a friend, a very wonderful man. His name is Rod Mason. He's a lawyer. And he says, people oftentimes say to me, well, I just want what I deserve. And his comment with a smile is, no, you don't. We don't ever want what we deserve. But we'll try and decide what it is you do want. Yeah. To live with God, to receive his great creative power is grace that is amazing. It's not a quid pro quo. However, I just simply ask you, is there in any way a God quid pro quo? Does he have expectations of you and me? Is there something that he wants you and I to do? Well, the rich young ruler asked Jesus, how may I have what you have? How may I have eternal life? And Jesus said, well, hey, go sell all that you have and give to the poor. Then follow me. Was that a quid pro quo? I'll just let that sit on your head for a while, because today, on this Wednesday, I'm going to take a little time as I approach 2020 to say, okay, dear God, what are the things that you want me to do? Give me some expectations in my prayers and meditation and wisdom. What are some of the things that you want me to do to better follow you, to know you, to love you, to serve you, and to share your love with others? Dear God, are there any quid pro quos that we should work on in 2020? Just let that little thought sit on your head for a while. I'm Stan Houston, the Master Entrepreneur. We'll finish it up. We'll be right back. Hopefully something to think about. One of the little fun lines that I use, because it was used on me, a gentleman leaned forward right into me and said, Mr. Houston, tell me something I don't know. What a challenge. Tell me something I don't know. And that was part of a job audition. Tell me something I don't know. So I've kind of picked that up for years. Say, hey, tell us something we don't know. Help us learn something new. And so one of the things we're going to try and do from time to time is to see if we can tell you something that you didn't know that might be helpful to you. And we'll be during this giving season. It's 6 weeks from 2020. January 1st, 2020, 6 weeks from today. During the giving season, we're going to try and give you a little tip, 3 to 4, maybe a few times more a week. Just a 3 to 5 minute little coaching connection, a coaching counsel that hopefully it'll be something that you didn't know that will be helpful and useful to you. That's part of our plans to serve you and to give you some help with grace during the giving season of 2020. I'm Stan Houston. Thank you for your time and energy. Thank you for your sponsorship and the things that you do for me and that you do for the Christian Entrepreneur Network. We are profoundly grateful. All the best. Bye for now.